pornography, and yes, we are injured. Welcome back, and Assalamu alaikum. This is the last part. How will the family unit be destroyed? The demand alone will throw the whole ideology of the family into question, so that women can begin establishing community of work with each other and we can fight collectively. Women will feel freer to leave their husbands and become economically independent either through a job or welfare. Female liberation, Roxanne Dunbar. We can't destroy the inequities between men and women until we destroy marriage. Robin Morgan, Sisterhood is Powerful. It is important for us to encourage women to leave their husbands and not to live individually with men. All of history must be rewritten in terms of oppression of women. We must go back to ancient female religions like witchcraft. The Declaration of Feminism, November 1971. Life in this society being, at best, a nutter bore and no aspect of society being at all relevant to women, there remains to civic-minded, responsible, thrill-seeking females only to overthrow the government, eliminate the money system, institute complete automation, and destroy the male sex. Valerie Solana, Society for Cutting Up Men. Only when manhood is dead and it will perish, when ravaged femininity no longer sustains it. Only then will we know what it is to be free. Andrea Durkin. Here's how the scheme to destroy the family is mapped out. The Atlantic Monthly, July 1926. The Russian Effort to Abolish Marriage. Volume 138, Number 1. Page 108-114. Eliminate the sacredness of the marriage covenant from the minds of the masses. Make them believe marriage is outdated and blase. Inspire hatred against the family unit, manhood and fatherhood. Institute no-fault divorce and encourage serial divorces. Incite rampant promiscuity, fornication and adultery. Make having illegitimate children become a common practice. Convince society that a child in the womb is not a human being. Provoke women to have abortions without regard to God or their consciences. Make true love seem like cheap amusement. Stimulate the people to confuse sex with love. Create an environment that encourages unwed single motherhood. Inspire men to disrespect, dishonor and abuse women. Design laws that motivate women to commit paternity fraud. Incite homosexuality, lesbianism, sexual immorality and perversion. Influence men to effortlessly abandon children they sire. Most importantly, provoke a fierce, relentless gender war. Is there anybody reading this who can't draw parallels with their own society? The most merciful thing a large family can do to one of its infant members is to kill it. Margaret Sanger, founder of Planned Parenthood in Women and the New Rage. But why?
I wasn't ready!
I have no arms and no legs, but I'm very thankful that I have my little chicken drumstick here. People freak out when they see me for the first time. It's so cool. I was at a water slide all by myself. Everyone obviously at the bottom of the slide is looking up and waiting for other people to come down. And here I come and they're freaking out. They're like, you know, like this. And I was so tempted to look at myself and go, what happened? You know? There were times where I sort of looked at my life and thinking, well, I can't do this and I can't do that. And you keep on concentrating on the things that you wish you had or the things that you wish you didn't have. And you sort of forget what you do have. And there's no point, I believe, in my life where I wish I had arms, legs, I wish I had arms, legs, I wish I had arms, legs, because wishing won't help. But what I've seen in life are just a couple key principles, and the first thing that I've seen is to be thankful. It's hard to be thankful, man. I tell you, when I was 8 years old, I sort of summed up my life and thought, I'm never going to get married. I'm not going to have a job. I'm not going to have a life of purpose. What kind of a husband am I going to be if I can't even hold my wife's hand? It's a lie to think that you're not good enough. It's a lie to think that you're not worth anything.
One point.
It's freezing, I can't feel my hands.
I love life. You know, so many people come and say, how come you smile so much? And I'm like, well, it's a long story. But it's very simple at the same time. You see, it's very hard to smile sometimes in life. There are things that happen that you don't know and you don't understand, and you don't know if you're going to get through it. You know, you go through your storms in life and you don't know how long this storm is going to be. And today I want to share with you some principles that I've learned in my life that you can use in yours. Being patient is beautiful. I tell you, it's the hardest thing. But I realize I may not have hands to hold my wife's hand, but when the time comes, I'll be able to hold her heart. I don't need hands to hold her heart.
You know, it is scary to know how many girls have eating disorders. It is scary to know how many people are just angry at life because of their situation at home and angry at others.
It's scary to know how many people actually feel like they're worth nothing. Every single girl right here, right now, I want you to know that you are beautiful. You are gorgeous just the way you are. And you boys,
you're the man.
But they also know these things. Then why? And then, what is their real agenda behind this?
We are against homosexuality because the Bible very clearly, God says, I hate it. Don't do it. By the way, homosexuality is a great way to control the population. And do you understand? I'm serious about this. And I've seen this in lots of places, that the entity that we would call the Illuminati, which is really over above Freemasonry, has stated it as their goal to limit the world population to no more than 500 million. Do you realize that means getting rid of all of us? Because there's between 6 and 7 billion people in the world today. And to get from 6 to 7 billion down to 500 million, you're going to have to kill a lot of people off. What do you think the health care bill is? Oh, yes, it's a death culture. And what do you think? What about homosexuality? That's a great way to limit the population.
This has been in the agenda for a long time. They control the media, they control the politics, they control the pharmaceutical cartel and the other corporations. They control the political parties that can run the governments. There's one thing they don't have: numbers. Global population is now 7 billion. They want to dramatically reduce the population so that, for their point of view, they have a population number they can handle, because they can't handle this one. And this is why it's so important for people to understand this.
David Icke gets down to specifics, how the murders will take place.
The idea is to target the human immune system. There is a war on the human immune system through food additives and additives to drink. All of them are chemically targeting the human immune system.
The American Stonehenge. A mysterious man who called himself R.C. Christian commissioned a local company to build it. Then he disappeared, leaving behind 6 granite slabs and a message repeated in 8 languages. It says in part, "Let all nations resolve disputes in a world court, unite humanity with a new language, and maintain humanity under 500 million under 500 million. Some may dispute the figure, but the chilling message is literally written in stone.